Welcome to Tactical Talk. This is Zan Khan. Today, the topic of our show is the importance of Pakistan's Navy in South Asia and also Pakistan's Navy's future projects. Today, our first and special guest is Pakistan's former Chief of Naval Staff and also Pakistan's former Ambassador to Saudi Arabia, Admiral Shahid Karimullah. Out of many awards, Government of Pakistan has awarded Admiral Karimullah Nishan-e-Imtiaz Tar-e-Jurat. Our second guest is Captain Adeep Safvi, a senior geopolitical analyst. Welcome to our show, Admiral Karimullah. This is Zan Khan. It is a pleasure having you on Tactical Talk.
Welcome.
Welcome to our show, Captain Safvi. It's always a pleasure having you.
Zan, always a pleasure to talk to you. Always a pleasure. Thank you.
Let's get to the first question. And Admiral Karimullah, I'd like to ask you, how has the role of naval power evolved over the years in South Asia? Would you say it has diminished or acquired greater importance in the regional power matrix?
Well, Pakistan Navy came into being after the partition in 1947. Prior to that, it was the Royal Navy operating in these areas. When we became independent, the Royal Navy distributed their units which were stationed here in the subcontinent between Pakistan and India. Both of them got very old units and we started our Navy from scratch. Later on, slowly and gradually, we started inducting more units. But unfortunately for Pakistan, we always had old ships to buy from UK mostly, and then later on from the United States. Now, all the time we had these ships, especially the surface ships, which were 30 years old, averaging. We had no aviation, we had no subsurface fleet. Now, in 1965, the Dwarka operation brought the Pakistan Navy into limelight, especially within Pakistan. Then later on in 1971, both navies saw action and both navies suffered war casualties. Both the navies lost ships. We had operated our submarines, and our submarines made a great impact in Pakistan as well all over the world, especially the Exocet missile that we had acquired. Later on, again, the things started getting, now that the CPEC has come in, the Navy's requirement has increased many folds. The Indian Navy, right from the start, had an edge in size. That means at that time also, they were 1:8. Even now, Pakistan Navy is much smaller in size, but certainly we do not lack the quality. We are inducting now new ships, new submarines, and also in the past, new aircraft. So therefore, now we have a complete three-dimensional Navy, and so does India. So therefore, I would say over a period of time, the importance of both the regional powers has not diminished at all. It is, in fact, increasing day by day.
Captain Safvi, how important is it for Pakistan to possess a credible naval force to safeguard our sea lines of communication, especially now that we are becoming an integral hub for BRI and CPEC?
Thank you, Zan. Continuing from where the Admiral has left, I think it is important for the people to realize that maritime power or naval power is one of the 17 elements of national power. And once you see the structure of the naval strategy or maritime strategy, it falls in two domains. Number one, it is military strategy, which gives its input to the naval strategy, and then maritime strategy, which has the commercial activity as well, that gives the impetus to again to naval strategy. So the naval forces have to be created or maintained in a manner that can provide you a very solid defense to your sea lines of communication, because commercial activity will determine how large the Navy should be, how many naval merchant ships you have, what is your quantity of trade, sea trade, going through your slugs. And so far as we are concerned, most important factor is the oil that we get from the Middle East. It is very important that we maintain the sea lines of communication so that the oil continues to come in, because this is one single most important factor which will determine our stamina for war. If we are able to maintain the flow of oil, we will be able to sustain the war. So I think the naval forces that we have now come, that as Admiral Shahid described, we have a three-dimensional force. As a matter of fact, a fourth dimension has also been added, which is called the Naval SEALs or Marines. So the Navy is, mashallah, now in a very comprehensive state to discharge its responsibility, both in terms of saving the sea lines of communication and the sea frontiers inward. So I think we are very well equipped to deal with our responsibility.
Admiral Karimullah, would you want to comment on what Captain Safi just said?
Yes, I will like to add something. I agree totally with Safi, but I would like to add here that Pakistan Navy recently have changed or rather amended its entire organization into task force. And there are three task force. Earlier, we used to think about the defense of Karachi Harbor only. But now these task forces have been made into three, so that each port, that is Karachi, Urmara and Gwadar, each is protected by independent command. This is the major change that we have taken place this time.
Admiral Karimullah, with India's hegemonic aspirations driving it to develop a blue water navy, how will the Pakistan Navy ensure that we can thwart any Indian offensive on our SLOCS and ports?
India has surely developed into a navy in its blue water navy, and because of its hegemonic aspirations. Pakistan Navy has no such aspirations. Our strategy or PN strategy has always been a defensive offensive strategy. Moreover, earlier we had only Karachi port to defend, whereas now we have two more, Urmara and Gwadar, to defend. And this adds to our burden and our area of our responsibility. However, Pakistan Navy, according to the money given to it by the government, have very carefully and intelligently is acquiring modern fleet, modern ships, modern submarines and aircraft to cover its entire area so that we can detect the enemy forces well in time and react to it. The foremost thing is that earlier Air Force, Pakistan Air Force, used to dedicate certain aircraft to Pakistan Navy, but recently it has dedicated and allocated a complete squadron of JF-17s to Pakistan Navy. So this enables us to detect our enemy much in advance and then react with our Air Force as well as our own assets. So therefore, I feel that at present, we may not be able to compete with the Indians as far as the number and the size is concerned, but certainly we are capable to defend our coast effectively.
Captain Safi, what's your analysis on what Admiral Shahid Karimullah just said?
Yes, I'll add here, Indian hegemonic designs are very well explained by the Admiral. I would like to add here that Navy is an instrument of foreign policy. And as the Mao Zedong had said, that foreign policy flows out of the barrel of the gun. So the naval forces inherently have the capability to go across the shores to any place in peacetime as well, and yet change the role into an offensive one if it's required, and that's how it is used as an instrument of foreign policy. Now, for that, Indian have created their naval force around the aircraft carrier and other major units, which are really power projection platforms So we are concerned, as the Admiral has said, we never had an offensive design, so we don't have a carrier. But the technology of both in terms of detection, in terms of weapons, have changed drastically, and smaller units have been created which can threaten or which can challenge these big units, and their projection of power can be intercepted. So I think as a small force, Pakistan Navy has acquired the capability of countering this effect of challenging our sea lines of communication or threatening our frontiers.
Captain Safi, we are witnessing an evolution in India's warfighting doctrine as it repostures its forces under the Cold Star Doctrine and is attempting to unhinge the traditional value of nuclear deterrence by attempting surgical strikes, as we have witnessed post-Pulwama. Do you see the Navy playing a supportive role or a primary role in future Indo-Pak skirmishes or limited wars?
Yes, if you recall, in the recent past, we have seen Indian activities along our coastline, sending the submarine and other units. But as the Admiral had rightly said, that we have the capability of detecting them well in time, and we are able to, we'll be able to deal with the threat as it emanates. But certainly, Indian Navy would like to create a situation where, while the battle or while the threat is predominantly over land, but the sea also poses a great challenge to us. And hence, it would be required that we remain vigilant, and with the air surveillance and other means that are available to us, we utilize them so that we can detect them well in time and take appropriate action.
Admiral Karimullah, how do you see Pakistan's Navy's role post-Pulwama?
Yes, I would say that Pulwama-type attacks are likely to take place more frequently in the future. And it appears that the long-drawn war between the two countries have considerably reduced. I personally feel that in the last Pulwama attacks, or skirmishes as we call, it was the Pakistan Air Force which was tested, not the Pakistan Navy, although Navy was fully alert. In future, if similar things happen, and especially if they apply the Cold War doctrine, and I think the Pakistan Navy will not be in a supportive role, but will take part in a completely primary role.
Admiral Karimullah, we are witnessing a greater emphasis on the indigenization in our military. The Pakistan Air Force has developed the JF-17 Thunder and drones, while the Pakistan Army has built Al-Khalid tanks. Can you tell us some projects and initiatives taken by the Pakistan Navy to develop indigenous flagship weapon systems?
Yes, like our sister services, the Pakistan Army and Pakistan Air Force, Navy is also actively pursuing development of indigenously flagship weapon systems. Now, when I call it the weapon system, we must also discuss and talk about the platforms as well. In the surface fleet, Pakistan Navy has been able to acquire for the first time new, brand new surface ships in 2006. At present, we have 4 Milgram class corvettes from Turkey being built. 2 are being built in Turkey and the 2 are being built in Pakistan shipyard. In addition to this, we have 4 corvettes which are actually Dutch design, but being built by Romania. 2 will be built there and 2 will be built in here. Similarly, we have 8 submarines of Chinese design under construction in Karachi shipyard and engineering works. And the most important is that we have been able to build indigenously surface to air missiles, which have a range of about 70 kilometers. These are under testing and production. Similarly, we have area denial weapons by the name of Zarb missile, and that is developed and operational. It has a about a range of 100 plus kilometer range. Harba, which is surface to surface a cruise missile, but this is a missile which is used from surface, that means shore, to against surface ships. Then we have the version of for second strike capability, we have a missile developed which is known as a Babur missile, and that has the second, that gives us the second strike capability. And I think the Indians at present should be most worried about this missile, which has a range of about 400 plus kilometers. In electronic warfare, we have started building electronic support measures, and we are still working on the electronic countermeasure. So I think we are doing, the Pakistan Navy is doing quite satisfactory in indigenous production, although we have got a lot of support from the Chinese.
Captain Safi, you look like you want to add something.
Yes, I think the most important thing that the Admiral has missed out is that he is the man responsible for bringing new ships into the Pakistan Navy. It was during his tenure that the contracts were signed for building these ships in China and in Pakistan, and that set the ball rolling. And now, mashallah, we have contracts and transfer of technology taking place from various countries where we are building these ships, and the indigenous capability has got a great boost, which for which he should be given the credit. Thank you.
Admiral Karimullah, please give us some insight on the project Captain Safi just mentioned.
Well, when I was a fleet commander before becoming the Chief of Naval Staff, I had realized that Pakistan Navy very badly needed to buy new ships, surface ships. We had submarines, we had aircraft, which we had bought new, but not the surface ships. So therefore, I had made up my mind, if ever I get into that position, I will buy new surface ships. So when I got a chance, I approached the Chinese, and they were very much obliged and happy to help us out. And that is the time when I managed to get a contract to build four warships, three in China and one in Pakistan. The major impact of this was not only new ships, but because our shipyard was almost going bankrupt, because of this, the shipyard, and because of that new life you see now, they are building a lot of ships, missile boats. In fact, almost all the ships that are being built, even abroad, are under the transfer of technology. And the shipyard is now fully capable of building these ships. So this has got a double impact, not only new ships, but also our shipyard has become capable and fully operational.
Captain Safi, as military observation capabilities rapidly improve with technological advances and oceanic surveillance becomes more robust, do you foresee a greater emphasis on enhancing underwater naval capabilities in the future, or would surface naval assets still play a crucial role in safeguarding a nation's maritime interests, in your opinion?
Good, thank you very much. I think this is a very, very important aspect of naval warfare. Submarine or subsurface forces play a very decisive role in both offensive and defensive capability. So, so far as the technology is concerned, we would perforce be required to invest more in the subsurface capability, that is submarine, to create the offensive punch that we require. While the surface ships and aircraft and other will be required to defend the sea lines of communication or the sea frontiers, the only platform available to us for an offensive capability is the submarine. So I think as the time passes, we will have to keep abreast with the development of the platform, that is the subsurface platform, in creating that punch capability to deal with the offense in enemy ships and aircraft carrier.
Admiral Karimullah, would you want to comment on what Captain Safi just said?
Yes, I think I agree with Captain Safi. He had earlier also mentioned that navies are four-dimensional. And that is very true. A submarine is a one-dimension. Subsurface is a one-dimension. A lot of people have this concept in the mind that submarine is a defensive capability or it's a defensive platform. No, submarine is a totally offensive platform, and basically it's a project, or its purpose is to disrupt these locks, disrupt the sea lines of communication of the enemy. And now submarines are becoming more and important as far as this aspect is concerned. Now, since we have the second strike capability now, the submarines have added its role. That is that staying away much further from the enemy coast, they can fire their missiles well into the enemy area. Now this again, I would say that this should be the capability that should worry the Indians the most.
Admiral Karimullah, lastly, I would like to ask if you have any message for our younger generation who would like to join the Pakistan Navy, because obviously you've led the Pakistan Navy in the past and they'd like to listen to you. You would be an inspiration for them.
Yes, I have a message for them, all the young lot, that defense of any country is one of the most noble causes. If you ever join the Navy with this cause in mind. Never ever underestimate your enemy. Your enemy is considerably and much larger than what you are in number of fighting units. So in order to counter its strength in numbers, we have to have an upper hand in technical know-how. And if we don't have an upper hand in the technical field, then at least we should have a parity. Overcoming any shortcomings, we need to exceed in our profession, discipline, hard work, and above all, in faith in Allah. Always think that you can do for your country and not what country can do for you.
Thanks so much, Admiral Shahid Karimullah, for being on Tactical Talk. It was a pleasure having you.
Welcome.
Thank you so much, Captain Adeep Safwi. It's always a pleasure having you on our show.
Thank you very much. Always a pleasure with you.
This was former Pakistan's Chief of Naval Staff, Admiral Shahid Karimullah, and our second guest, a senior geopolitical analyst, Captain Adeep Safwi. We were discussing the topic of the importance of Pakistan's Navy in South Asia and also Pakistan's Navy's future projects. Until the next episode of Tactical Talk, this is Ayan Khan. Keep on watching Tactical Talk. Take care and goodbye.